In the next question, a continuous time signal x of t is passed through a sampler and whose sampling rate fs is 100 hertz. Output of sampler is x of n and we have to obtain fundamental time period of signal x of n. Now, first of all, we have to convert this discrete, this continuous time signal x of t into its discrete version. Now, to convert x of t into discrete form, we will replace variable t by nts. Now, as we know, ts and fs are inversely proportional, so we can write down ts, or we can replace ts by 1 by fs. So fs is 100 hertz, it is already given. Now, to obtain discrete signal, we will replace this variable t with term n by 100. So we will write down in this way: 10 cos 50 pi into n by 100 plus 3 pi upon 4. So this 50 term will be, these two terms will be cancelled out, and xn will be like this: 10 cos pi by 2n plus 3 pi by 4. Now, we have obtained another periodic signal whose omega naught is pi by 2. Now, for x of n, the value of omega naught is pi by 2. To obtain its fundamental time period, formula will be like this: 2 pi upon omega naught into k. So it will be equal to 2 pi upon pi by 2 into k. So this term will be equal to 4k. Now, in case of discrete time signaling, now here k is an integer. K is a least integer value, least integer value for which capital N, or fundamental time period, is an integer. To obtain N as an integer, we will put least integer value of k 1. So if we will put k equals to 1, then we will obtain fundamental time period 4. So for this question, fundamental time period of discrete signal x of n is